have bestowed upon you our knowledge, which will hopefully enrich your life as you move on into your next chapter. I want all of you to understand that knowledge is information, but wisdom comes from the application of that information. With this being said, let's talk about success. You cannot achieve success without first experiencing failure. It is that bitter, disappointing feeling of lack of accomplishment that drives us to overcome what we thought we couldn't. The funny thing about success is that it's widely misunderstood and misrepresented. I have no doubt that if I were to ask 10 people what they thought success was, it would equate it with a monetary value. If I were to ask, who are successful people? I am sure people would respond with the name of some rich person or a celebrity. We do that because that is the way that we are conditioned to think. For me, as I stand here and look out into the audience, as I look into each and every one of your faces, I see successful people. Successful people are ordinary people, such as yourself, such as me, who will do what the average person doesn't feel like. You have pushed yourself to earn the right to be standing here today in this moving on ceremony. As Vince Lombardi famously told his players, and this is why I say it's important to always look at a dictionary. Only in the dictionary will you find that success comes before work. So fifth grade students of Cross Point Elementary, each and every one of you sitting here today is successful because success is defined as the accomplishment of one's goals. As you go on to different levels in your life, I hope that each of you set small, realistic goals for yourself. Make them manageable so that they can be attained. This way, with each accomplishment, you will taste the sweetness of success. The faith you have in yourself will determine the fate of yourself. And remember, knowledge is power, but only when it is shared. Congratulations, fifth grade, and thank you for your attention.
And now, we are ready for a musical presentation for Ms. Watson. Her name is Ariana Pierre Lewis. Ariana is a graduate of Suncoast High School as well as Florida State University, graduate of Magna Cum Laude, and her Bachelor of Science in Family and Child Services. She wants to become a marriage family therapist in the future, but tonight she's going to give you some words of wisdom. Ladies and gentlemen, Ariana Pierre Lewis.
Good evening, everyone. As you just heard, my name is Ariana Pierre Lewis. I am from West Palm Beach, Florida, and I recently graduated Magna Cum Laude with a Bachelor of Science degree in Family and Child Sciences from Florida State University in Tallahassee. First off, I would like to congratulate you all on this wonderful achievement. You made it through elementary school, and now middle school is right around the corner. When I was in your place 11 years ago, I was so happy to celebrate, but also nervous about what the future held for me. I would be forced to enter a new environment, meet new people, and learn new things. I'm here to let you know that the fear or worry you may be feeling will turn into joy and gratitude each and every time. Of course, change may seem scary, but it opens up the door to so many opportunities and experiences. I had to face the start of middle school, the start of high school, the start of college, and now the start of adulthood. I was nervous each time, but also cherished every moment. Have you ever heard anyone say, you get out of it what you put into it? Without a doubt, this is true. It takes motivation, determination, and effort to achieve successful results. You have to be the one to face this change. You have to be the one to put in the work. It all starts with you. Aside from putting in work, always remember to give thanks. None of this would have been possible alone. Whether you have a big village or a small group, any help giving counts. I would not have made it this far without the love and support from the people in my life. They have pushed me to reach my goals in all areas of life and were always there to lend a helping hand when times got tough. Now look around the room. This is what support looks like. Family, friends, classmates, teachers, and staff. These people have been rooting for you from the start and will continue to do so beyond elementary. Give appreciation to them the way they give support to you. Now this one, I'm sure you've heard many times, but it is a major key. Be confident. Effort and support are important, but they can't complete the job without confidence. You have to believe in yourself. It will be challenging to give your all on the outside when there's negativity on the inside. Each and every one of you is capable of great things. You all have the potential to achieve great success. The people, celebrities, and icons you look up to face obstacles just like you, but the confidence they hold helps them overcome them. Even with all the tools available, a lack of confidence will continue to set you back. Don't let that fear or worry creep back up and take over. You can do this. Know each and every time that you can do this. My grandparents, who are descendants of Haiti, came to this country to build a foundation that will provide their family with opportunity. My parents have instilled in me the values of life needed to obtain success. With a combination of effort, support, and confidence, a Haitian American girl like me was able to go on and graduate from one of the top public universities in the nation. In the future, there will be moments similar to mine where you feel that sense of fulfillment. Just like right now, this is one of these moments. I'm very proud of you guys and can't wait to see all the things that you do in the future. Congratulations once again. Have a wonderful summer and put your best foot forward in everything that you do. Thank you.
Thank you again. Ariana Pierre Lewis, give her a round of applause, please. Keep her hallways safe, telling kids not to run, tie shoes, tuck shirts in, all across our rules. If you're safe control, do us a favor, please rise, turn to the crowd, acknowledge yourself, please. Give them a round of applause.
I was so excited that chorus and trumpet could resume this year. We've taken a break for a little bit. And thank you, parents, for getting your students to rehearsal and picking them up after school. I really appreciate it. I'd like to recognize the following students for their outstanding contribution to Cross Point Chorus this year. When I call your name, please stand and turn around. Johan Ramirez.
Yeah, right.
with Yoma.
Presidential awards. Very, very distinguished awards. Or we we start, though, let me tell you the criteria for these awards. We have silver, we have gold. If you're a gold presidential achievement winner, you're receiving 4 or 5 level on the FSA in reading or the 4th grade math. Mostly PRs on the 4th and 5th grade report cards. And if you're a silver, you've actually got an achievement, you've made improvement this year throughout the entire 5th grade year academically. With this award comes a letter from the White House, which I'm going to read to you, signed by our President, Joseph Biden. And I'm going to read it directly, I'm not going to read it personally. Congratulations on receiving the 2022 President's Education Award. Young leaders like you are why the First Lady and I are more optimistic about the future than ever before. This award is a testament to your hard work, tenacity, and perseverance, especially during these difficult times. You showed your family, friends, school, and community what you can accomplish, and you should be very, very, very proud. You are the part of the most gifted and talented generation in our history, and the world is going to need you. Keep studying hard and remember to always lead by example. I have every confidence that you will translate your talents into greater opportunities, happiness, and prosperity for yourself, our nation, and the world. Your future is bright. Keep the faith, President Joseph Biden. We're going to pass out these. When we call your names, please come up on stage. These are the silver awards. Alan Fabio East Lewis. Andre Allen. Ethan Ardilla. Natalia Acevedo Allen.
Joseph Kai. Chloe Laverdin. Elijah Mondesi.
Donovan.
Stephanie Lusson. Jonas Simpson. And last but not least, Kiana Williams. Give it up for your fifth grade gold presidential award. You guys have a great time. Okay. Now, we'd like to present the end of the year completion certificates. Starting with Mr. Brown's class. Thank you.
Baby Bryce. Jayla Charles. Devontae Charles. Brianna Allen. Ariana DeJill. Josiah Christine. John Hanson. Kalia Harris. Eunice Jean.
Jean Baptiste. Carter Joseph. Joseph Chloe Laverde.
Thank you. Sure. I had the privilege to teach some of your children in third grade, and then I went to Commitment. I had them again, and I was so happy. Honestly, you guys have been, if not the best, one of the top best fifth grades that I've ever had the privilege of teaching. Thank you, parents. Thank you. All right, so here we go. Last class. Sidlina Shirley. Carolina Fernandez. Congratulations, you missed it. Just give a round of applause to all the fifth graders.
Back to work.
Let's also give a round of applause to our fifth grade teachers.
So this part's kind of hard. Let's been with me for 6 years. They're like, they're my babies. And I'll let them off the fly. But remember, first come back, and you can come back and visit me.
Back us up then.
I would like to take this time to thank you special people in the audience. Thank you, Winston, for attending. Thank you.
For the last time this evening, we hear clap.
Sure.
I have to do the